Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Are you ready to learn how to put wow factor into the Doobie Brothers? Listen to the music? Well, meet me in this studio. Let's do it. Gaylerd here. Hey, this is going to be a great song for you to learn. This is that Doobie Brothers classic hit, Listen to the Music. And I'm going to show you how to do it with one guitar to put all that wow factor into it. You've already heard that little slide that we're going to do, right? And then I'm going to show you how to do some bass fills in there. This song, man, this is going to be a lot of fun. So why am I talking, doing all of this stuff? Let's get into the studio and let's learn how to play Listen to the Music. You're going to love this one. Okay, let's start off by showing you what chords we're going to play on this song. Now, normally I tell you that when you play by yourself with one guitar, you want to play as many open chords as you can to get that full, robust sound. But this particular song, we're going to need to play the bar chords with it, a few bar chords anyway. So let me show you what we're going to do. You're going to C sharp minor, and I'll put the diagrams up there because I know that's always hard to see on a C sharp minor. You're going to play a barred A. You see that? Bar A, an F sharp, an E. We're going to play a D chord, but we're going to play the D chord as a bar chord. And that's just about it. Now you got a couple of little licks up here that we're playing, but I'll just show you the chord diagrams for those. All right, those are the chords we're going to use. Now let's get started and learn how to use them. Okay, that opening intro. What you're doing is you're going to take your index finger and you're going to put them across the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. But you're not going to play that first string. You're really just playing those 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Except that you're playing that open 6th string also. Okay? Don't bar it, but you're just going to be playing that open just to get that fullness in there. Okay, so here's what we're doing. That first lick, you're just taking that little like a hammer on with your ring finger going up here. You're on the 9th fret of the 5th string, and you're going to take that ring finger and do a hammer on up to the 9th fret of that 5th. I'm sorry, 9, 10, 11th fret. So it's like this. Okay. And, you know, there's different ways. I never play it the same way twice. So just do some hammer-ons in there. You know the feel for the song. You know the intent. So that's what you want to get. And then here we're going to change. And there's your chord diagram. Okay. Put that wow factor into this song. Here's what I want you to do. You know what your chord is. You're going to do a slide. You're going to take that index finger and you're going to slide with, and you're hitting your 6th, 5th, and maybe even your 4th string. But for sure you hit that 6th and 5th string and just do a slide to get up to your hammer. So you slide up to the 9th fret and then you're hammering with that ring finger. So like this. All there is to it. Now let's learn the chords to the verses. Now he actually starts on the verses. He actually does that same little riff. Don't you think it, or, well, I don't know what even the words are, but There's your first chord. There's your diagram. Okay, there's your B. I may have left that B out at the beginning. There's an A. Okay. Now, here's what I want you to do. When you're hitting that on those chords there, you hear what I'm doing on that little on that sixth string on that A? I'm just taking my index finger off of that fifth fret on the sixth string. I'm getting a little bit of a bass run there, so it goes. So now, when you do that twice, and then you're going to go down to the, a C sharp minor. Listen to the music. Whoa, whoa, listen to the music. Okay, and all that is. But what we're going to do here, we're going to get those bass riffs in there for that wow factor again. And what you're going to do here on your C sharp minor, you want to take your index finger and you're going to do like that. All we're doing is on the fourth fret of the fifth string and the sixth string. Just like that. So it goes. Then you go to that A, and what we're going to do there, well, that keeps coming in and out. What you want to do on that A to get your bass riff, you just lift it up. Okay, now that may sound a little funny like that, but I can promise you, when you're playing that song, it'll sound great. In fact, stick around to the end of this song, or the end of this lesson, because I'm going to put a little clip of my band Acoustic Shade playing this, and you'll hear what it sounds like with just one guitar in there. You'll hear all these little bass riffs. So it goes like this. Again, let's try that. This is whoa, whoa, listen to the music, right? So it goes whoa. Sharp all the time, and I'm doing the same thing on that F sharp that I do on the A. I'm just lifting that index finger up. Okay, so it goes whoa. F sharp, chord right there, and that's just a regular A. Now, what I'm doing there is I'm going to be lifting my finger up, my pinky up, and it kind of makes it like an A2. And I'm just doing that to get that nice little flavor in there. So watch the strumming on it. Now, if you'll notice, my hand has got a nice smooth strumming action, and I'm doing that, what I call accent strumming. My hand's going fluid, but sometimes I'm hitting those strings up, down. It's just whatever that, I want to get that nice flavor into it. And the intent of the song, that's what's important, playing the intent of the song. So, well, I hope you're enjoying the lesson, and we'll get right back to it in just a moment. But right now, you know, you're enjoying another free lesson that's taking you a step closer to becoming the guitar player you've always wanted to be, right? Aw, come on, you know it's right. Well, if you've been blessed by my lessons, please visit my YouTube channel, Gaylerd Guitar, and help support what I'm doing by donating something. You may be financially blessed where you can donate $25 or $50 or more. Or you may only be able to donate $3 or $5. Whatever amount you're comfortable with, please help me to continue teaching guitar and reaching lives with these videos. Because it costs a lot of time and money to create, produce, and edit a single tutorial, and I really need your support. Now, if you're financially strapped and can't afford to donate, then these lessons are my free gift to you. Thank you for your honesty with my honor system. Now let's get back to the lesson. And you do that slide again to get up there, right? second chord again. Now, there's only one other part that I'm going to show you, and that's where he goes, that lazy flowing river. I know a lot of people show you to play that D right there, and that's fine, you can. But if you want to get that flavor into it, here's what I like to do. I go up to that D with that bar, and the reason I do that because now I'm going to do a little bit of a slide down to that A. I'm doing that slide to get that wow factor into it. So it's castles in the sky. Okay, it goes down to an E, and then you're going to slide like that. So you're starting up on the ninth fret. So let's do that again. So it's lazy flowing castles in the sky. Now, when you get down to that A on this time, it goes. Now, this is where you're doing that, taking that finger off again. Doing that same little riff, right, where we're taking. Okay, there you go. And that's all you've got to it. Now that you'll do that ending a couple of times. I think we do it twice, but those are all the chords that you've got to play through that song, and you're going to love it. If you put those little bass riffs in there, people are going to love to hear you play this song. Now I got a treat for you. I'm going to let you listen to the way we play this song in my band. I'll put it up coming to you right now. Hope you enjoy this one. Thank you.
Subscribe now.